Every once in a while comes the time when you realize that a specific game contains everything the previous games had. Zombie Army Trilogy includes all the missions and content from Sniper Elite Nazi Zombie Army 1 and Nazi Zombie Army 2 in a single seamlessly connected video game. So why bother with multiple releases when a single one contains everything? That's a question for another day. In this video, we will solely be looking for a way to improve the FPS numbers in Zombie Army Trilogy. Let's get to it. This is not a typical benchmark video that will show you what it's like to play the game on certain hardware. This is a video that will show you what it's like to improve the performance of the game on certain hardware. Before we proceed with the optimization process, you will need to download and install the LowSpeaks Experience. The download link can be found in the description of this video. LowSpeaks Experience is a game optimization tool that I developed that will allow you to optimize your favorite games for maximum performance. So first of all, start the installation process for the LowSpeaks Experience. Once it's done, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut and select the optimization catalog. From the top of the menu, select the applicable digital platform and then select Zombie Army Trilogy from the drop-down menu. Once that is done, press load the optimization package. LowSpeaks Experience will now automatically check if the game version currently installed is supported by this optimization. If it is, press OK and the optimization control panel will load. When the optimization control panel loads, simply select the optimization presets and the resolution you would like to render your game at. This is something you will need to experiment on your own in order to see what works for the system the best. Once you decide which optimization presets and resolution you are going to use, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. Also, if you are not satisfied with what you see, you can always restore your game to default settings by choosing the Restore Default option. That's all from me for now. If you like what I do, please be sure to like the video and subscribe for more similar content. Anyway, I will see you all next time.